So tonight, yeah, we're gonna talk about social justice and inequality and racism and privilege, but we're gonna do it in the space of mindfulness and love. So let me ask you some questions. Who are you? What do you see when you look in the mirror? What does society see? What does the world see? What does America see when they look at you? Are you privileged? Are you prejudiced? Are you racist? And do you fit the profile? So I'm driving down the street and I stop at a red light. And I'm feeling tired from a long night as I slowly pull off as the light changes from red to green. So now I'm driving down the road and I look in my rearview mirror and I notice something strange. And I say to my wife, babe, something isn't right. I notice a car following closely behind us with their headlights turned on. And before she responds, I see bright police lights. So I slowly pull over to the side of an empty road that's barely lit. My heart is racing and I develop a lump in my throat. Look at my wife and I say, babe, this happens to me all the time. Just stay calm. Then two officers approach the vehicle. One officer shines a bright flashlight through the passenger side. And another officer approaches my side. I roll my window down halfway. And the officer says, you ran that red light. And I respond, no officer, sir, I did not run that red light. And then the officer says, let me see your license. I reach in my pocket and I take a deep sigh, realizing that I left my license and my wallet back at the school that I was working at. So I say with deep regret, sorry officer, I don't have my license or my wallet on me at this time. Then he says, well, give me your name, address, phone number, date of birth, social security number, work address, and work phone. And as I'm giving him all the information he needs, I still feel the bright light shining on my wife and on my baby girl. Then the officer says, we will be right back. So we sit in the car waiting 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, 45 minutes go by and officers return to the vehicle, one shining a bright flashlight and the other on my side with my window roll halfway down. And the officer says, I'm going to need you to take a fingerprint test. And I pause before I respond, and I watch as he pulls a black fingerprint pad out of his pocket. And I say, excuse me, officer, I've never heard of such a test. Could you please explain it to me in more detail? Now it's really silent. The tension is heavy. My heart is beating like a drum. And the officer responds with an angry tone, are you going to do it or not? I don't respond. And 7 to 10 seconds goes by, and then the officer reaches into the vehicle and tries to pull me out of the window that's more halfway down. His hands are around my jacket, and he's pulling and he's tugging on me. And my wife is screaming. His seatbelt is choking him. His seatbelt is choking him. And then the officer runs around and he pulls out some mace and he tells the sheriff who I spray you to. And then my wife manages to unbuckle me from my seatbelt, and then the officers pull me out of the window. And they slam me on the hard concrete street. They pick me up and slam me against the car 3 more times. And then one officer takes both his hands around my neck and he starts to choke me. Spit is flying from my mouth and I'm gasping for air. And then the officer says, "You're spitting on me? You're spitting on me." That is assaulting a police officer. And then while one officer is still choking me, the other officer yanks and pulls both my arms behind my back. And he yanks me so hard I feel something pop on my shoulder. And with the force of his pull, I hit the ground again. I'm not swinging, I'm just bracing myself for the fall. My body is tense. And then they pick me up, cuff me, and as they're shoving me into the squad car, and then suddenly the car stops. The officers pull me out of the car. They take the cuffs from off my wrist. I look around and it's black. It's completely dark. I freeze in terror. We stare at each other for what seems to be an eternity. They're not saying one word to me. And I'm frozen like a statue. And I tell myself, if you move, if you blink, if you sneeze, if you stumble, you will be shot or killed. So then the cops tightly place the cuffs around my wrist and shove me back into the squad car. So eventually the morning arrives and my bail is posted. And as I walk towards the back of the entryway, I see my wife. She rushes towards me, wraps her arms around me. Father, I see my mother, my brother, my family, my friends, my community. And as I'm standing in